Welcome to the show, viewers. I'm your host, Colin Sopio, and of course, you're coming live to you from Tidy's Restaurant Nakuru. For the best food, accommodation, soft drinks, and music, do make a point of visiting Tidy's Restaurant Nakuru, which is located along Oginga Oginga Street. This is Sporten TV, of course, your number one leading sports channel, matters sports and entertainment. I'm your host, Colin Sopio. Welcome to the show. On today's show, we are going to mainly focus on the semi-finals, the teams which have made it to the semi-finals, and the teams that will make it finally to the World Cup, to the finals of this World Cup Qatar 2022. On today's match, first we're going to start with Argentina versus Croatia. Just to remind you that currently Argentina is ranked third and Croatia is ranked number 12. So guys, which team do you think that will carry the day? First of all, we are going to discuss the tactics that both managers are going to use today. That is Scolani and Scolani, the Argentinian coach, and Zlatko Dabik, the Croatian tactician. Well, the quality of players first that Argentina has, it has Lionel Messi, the six-time Ballon d'Or champion, and is also the Argentinian captain. So, will Scolani really go with the same first 11 that did service to him when he faced the Dutch at the quarterfinals? Remember that this match went up to the penalties and Argentina finally won the match on penalties. Croatia on the other side faced the Samba Boys, that is the Brazilian team, the 2002 champions, and also this match went to penalties, and finally Croatia came out tops. So the question is, will the two tacticians, that is Scolani and Zlatko Dabik, will they go with the same first 11 that they did service for them in the last match? That is the question that we are waiting to see if it will happen. It's only a matter of time, and remember to keep it Sporten TV, where you'll be getting all the analysis as the match goes on. So, this Argentinian team, it has so many good players, the likes of Lionel Messi, as I had mentioned earlier, Angel Di Maria, Acuña, that is the Sevillian forward, and it also has Lautaro Martinez, who has been very quiet coming to this World Cup. They also have Martinez, that is Diego Martinez, between the sticks. And also the Croatian team is fairly a good team, led by the evergreen Luka Modric, the 37-year-old midfielder. It also have the likes of Dejan Lovric at the back. It also has the likes of the Chelsea midfielder in the name of Kovacic. So it is going to be a very tough match, but many are predicting that Argentina will carry the day, but it's a matter of wait and see. Briefly, I will just like to take you to on how the Argentinian managed to qualify to now this semi-final. And many are saying that the last match that Argentina played against the Dutch, Argentina could have won fairly, easily. But towards the end of second half, Argentina did show some complacency, which made Holland to come back to the game and equalize the match 2-2, and finally 12 penalties. And Argentina managed to hold their nerve, and they finally won the match. So will it be an easy task for them facing this Croatian team? This Croatian team is the second consecutive semi-final that they are playing. Remember that they also did the same in 2018 in Russia when they eliminated England. So I will kindly give you my predictions on today's match, and I think that this match will also go to the penalties and it will be a draw. And the match will be decided on penalties, and Croatia will finally have the day. These are my picks. Do feel free also to have your prediction. Remember, the best prediction that you can get and really get something out of it is only from Sport MTV. Analysis and prediction that you can really rely on. We'll be right back. Remember to keep it Sport MTV. View, like, subscribe, share, and also drop a comment in the comment section down below. I'm your host, Collins Opio. This is Sport MTV. Welcome back, guys, to the show. I'm your host, Collins Opio. And of course, this is Sport MTV, your number one leading sports channel, matters, sports, and entertainment. We are coming to you live from Dryden's restaurant, the best restaurant in Nakuru, for the best accommodation, drinks, music, and food. So, this is the second segment. And on this segment now we are going to focus on the next semi-final, that is Morocco against the mighty French. Remember that France is currently ranked 4th in the FIFA rankings, and Morocco is ranked number 22nd in the FIFA rankings. This French team coming to this competition have been on good form, and under the tutelage of Deschamps. I remember Deschamps is the same tactician that was with France in Russia, that is 2018. And Morocco is under Regragui. Please pardon my pronunciation, it's a very difficult name to pronounce. But I hope that you will bear with it. Morocco also has had a good run coming into this tournament. And of the last four teams that are remaining in this competition, Morocco is the lowest ranked team in Qatar, in the four teams that are remaining in Qatar. Let's start with Morocco. Firstly, Morocco coming to this tournament, many of fans and many units have written the Moroccans off, but they have surprised so many people. Morocco playing the last match against Portugal, defeating Portugal in fact sounded outlandish for many, but it was a surprise that was. Many could not define it, or maybe try to tell more of it, but Moroccan came on top in this match. Now, going towards the semi-finals, the Moroccans, these are the Atlas Lions, are facing France. Many are dubbing this duel as black and black affair, keeping in mind that France has a history of very many black players. From the era of Kylian Mbappé, Sidney Saini, up to now the likes of Kylian Mbappé, the likes of Kylian, the likes of Varane, they are all black. So many are dubbing this match as a black affair. So guys, let's get on to it. And with the French really managed now to defeat this Moroccan side. Moroccan side, their strength is mainly from their defense, that is their back four. They are using a very compact 4-3-3 formation, and they have only conceded just a single goal. So far, the best defensive record in this tournament, which deserves an applause. So, let us look at players that will determine this match which will be played tomorrow. The French are mainly focused on the French attack, which is led by Giroud. By the way, Giroud has managed to pick fall and finally break Henry's record as the French all-time goal scorer. The other person that we have to look in is Kylian Mbappe. Kylian Mbappe so far is the top scorer in this competition, having 5 goals. And so far he has been on fire. He has been on some on this tournament, and I think if France do make it to the final, I think we will be named as the player of the tournament. The other player is Antoine Griezmann, the Atletico Madrid center forward. He has been so quiet, but he has really managed to come up, come to the party, and really help this French team moving forward. Now, this front three of France is very difficult. So the question that lingers in many people's head is that, will they manage to break this stubborn, solid Moroccan defense, which has only left a single goal? Only time will tell. Now, let us move on to Morocco. These are the Atlas Lions. So far, they played Africa proud, and their players. Let us start with Messi, the hero who scored the goal that eliminated the Portuguese out of this competition. And the other player that we are going to mention is Hakim Ziyech, the Chelsea forward. Hakim Ziyech has really helped this Moroccan team moving forward, and his pinpoint passes trying to find the likes of the full and Amrabat in the middle of the park has really come in handy for this Moroccan side. It will be very wrong not to mention the keeper, the Moroccan keeper, that is Bono. Remember, Bono played this trade in Spain, in Sevilla, and yes, so far I think Bono is the goalkeeper of the tournament because he has only conceded a single goal. Some are arguing that will be the case because Morocco has had a very solid defense. So I think these are the main players of both teams that are going to come in, who will carry the game in this semi-final. My major concern about this Moroccan team is that the last match that we played against the Portuguese, one of the players was recorded and won't be available. And also their captain was fettered off, injured. So will it really have an impact coming to this match, now that Lenglet will be forced to ring in changes? Now, the question still remains, will the players that Lenglet brings in, will they really stand up with this Moroccan team, considering now that he will be left to tinker a bit with his formation, or will he stay in the same formation going forward? This is potentially your number one beauty sports channel, and remember, we are coming to you live from Titan's restaurant, the best restaurant in Nakuru, the best accommodation, best food, soft drinks, and even good music. Now, your prediction. I think that France will carry the day. Maybe we'll try to get me on this, considering that many are voting for Morocco to carry the day. But I think Morocco has really done African proud. But going past this stage, I don't think that we'll be in a position to make it. Considering that they have used so much energy from the group stage, they won that group. And also the same in the last match that they played against Morocco, against Portugal, it was high-octane match. Energy levels were so high. So I think fatigue will come to play a part in this match, considering that the French are so fresh. and they have bench power. They have players that they can call in from the bench and come between the mat, the likes of Kamavinga. So I think that it will be a very tight match, but I think by experience, the French will carry the day. Those are my predictions. Maybe you can also share us your prediction and maybe on the comment section area. I'm your host, Colin Sofio. It was nice doing another show for you guys. And I hope you keep on doing this more. Keep it Sport and TV. Keep viewing, keep subscribing, and don't forget to leave a comment on the comment section below. As for me and my team, it's bye-bye for now.